been wearing these masks. We know what it's like. I'm here in my home right now, no one around me, so I don't need my mask on. But we wanted to talk with one of the experts to find out what is truly the best way to wear our mask and how to properly take care of it so we know we are being safe during the pandemic. I'm pleased to be joined by Dr. Jody Lanko, who is the vice chair of the Department of Medicine for Lehigh Valley Hospital Hazleton. Thank you so much for joining us. Is there a right way and a wrong way to wear a mask? Give us the expert view on how we should properly do this so we all stay safe.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. So yes, the mask usage is incredibly important. And I tell my patients every day, if there's one way we can get our country and our world back to somewhat normalcy, it's going to be wearing your mask when you are not in your home. So like you said, I'm in my own office privately today, right now during this interview. So I'm not with other people right now, but all day, every day in my office, and anytime I'm outside of my home, I do wear my mask and my family does as well. And it is important to wear the mask at all times. And there are different versions of masks. So in terms of wearing it properly, the most important thing is that it is protecting your nose. So it's covering on top of your nose, in addition to as much of the area around and underneath your mouth as possible, to allow as few holes as possible, so that droplets or saliva cannot escape.
So we're wearing our mask. What are the benefits of wearing a mask for both me and you?
Sure. And that's, I think it's an incredibly important point, because at the beginning of this pandemic, we didn't really know how important the mask wearing was going to be, because this is the first time that the United States has been in a pandemic. And I think what we're seeing now is that initially we thought that if I wear a mask, it would just be protecting those around me. Now we seem to be seeing more evidence that if I wear a mask, it's as protective for me as it is for those around me. So yes, of course, it's going to stop my cough and sneeze from getting to people around me, but that physical barrier in front of the mouth, is in front of your mouth and your nose, is acting as a shield and preventing things from getting to you as well. So I think that's an incredibly important point, which we didn't really understand early on in the spring when we first started learning about coronavirus.
How long can I wear a mask like this? Do I just wear it like when I go to the grocery store and then throw it away? Can I reuse it? And also with the cloth masks, how long are they good for to wear? How often do we change them?
So, right. So with the surgical mask, they are designed to be one-time use. I will wear my mask with patients as long as it's not visibly soiled for the entire day. So you can take it on and off. Just be careful that if you do touch the outside of the mask, you do want to sanitize your hands afterwards. And that goes for whether you're touching the outside of your cloth mask or your surgical mask, anything like that. You want to be able to wash your hands after you touch the mask. But these surgical masks are designed to be disposable. The cloth masks, on the other hand, like you've suggested, again, can be worn for the most part for a day. We do recommend you washing them in the washing machine and drying them entirely at the end of each day, or if it gets visibly soiled.
One thing that I've noticed, some of my masks fit differently. Some of them are more loose, some of them are tighter. If it is too tight, is that a health risk itself, that you're not having enough room to breathe?
So they've actually done specific studies on this over the past few months, and they've tested oxygen levels, carbon dioxide levels on patients. And for the most part, as long as you are healthy and not wearing supplemental oxygen and carrying an oxygen tank around with you, it does not affect your oxygen level, does not cause you to have too much carbon dioxide. So it does fit better if it's a little bit tighter. It can be uncomfortable. That's something that we are getting used to as a society, but it is by no means causing any health hazard. If you are concerned, you can certainly talk to your healthcare provider about using your mask safely.
Is there anything else you want to say to our viewers? Because I think I've asked you all my questions.
No, I think the more we can, the more often and the more regularly you can get your friends and family to wear their masks when they're in public, especially when they're in group situations, and especially important when you can't maintain social distancing. And even when you can, it's incredibly important to wear your mask all the time. And that's the only way we're going to get out of this pandemic right now.
Today's news feature is brought to you by Frankie's Pizzeria, located at 3739 Wyoming Street in Hazleton. Every Friday night is all-you-can-eat crab legs from 5 until 8 p.m. Reservations are suggested. You can call 570-454-6000 to make a reservation or for more information.